Hello again. I'm Fred. This is Ross. And, dude, you're not supposed to laugh. Hello again. I'm Fred. This is Ross. And we're going to basically give everybody a quick rundown of why we did this and sort of do a step-by-step through each phase of this Rube Goldberg. We thought it would be something fun to do and interesting, and being engineers, you always want to go overboard, you always want to do the extreme, and you want to do the practical and practically. So we thought this would be something fun for the holidays. We started off this Rube Goldberg by using a microwave, and basically what we did is we put PVC in there and glued it to the glass plate and used a UV adhesive for that. And then we roped some fishing line through it and put it through the side of the microwave and drilled a hole in the top and brought the rope out the top. And we wanted to use, obviously, parts that weren't metal so we didn't have crazy sparks shooting all over the place. The idea of the microwave here was that it would pull string into the microwave, spool it around the PVC piping, and that pulling on the string would be what actually kicks Rudolph off to the next stage of the Rube Goldberg.
So for the second phase of our Rube Goldberg project, in hopes to try to get use out of the whole room, we wanted to try and find something to shoot across the room over a steel cabled zip line. And the idea we came up with was to have Rudolph attached to a clothesline pulley. And what we're going to do here is we were just going to put Rudolph on the pulley attached to some painter's tape. We used fishing string to get to the microwave in the previous step you just saw. And the idea behind it was with Rudolph stuffed with a little bit of weight to give him some speed going down the clothesline, we stuffed him with a baseball and some washers. And what we wanted to do to accomplish here was to attach some painter's tape to the baseball behind Rudolph. One of the challenging parts was the painter's tape stuck to Rudolph's fur here actually didn't come off very well. The microwave doesn't provide a whole lot of strength pulling the fishing line. So the challenging part in this step was to actually get the painter's tape to come off the baseball just right when the microwave pulls it. And the end result that we were looking for after the microwave was all said and done was for the painter's tape to be released just slightly enough to send Rudolph down the zip line. And the end result would look something like this.
So the third phase of the Rube Goldberg is Rudolph comes flying down the zip line. And basically, he's going to crash into Santa Claus, and Santa falls down the chimney and will crash into the first telecentric lens. Some of the things that were difficult here was Santa. When he was falling down the chimney, it was kind of hard to get a consistent hit with Rudolph because the zip line's bouncing, he's got a baseball in him, he's kind of waving side to side. And then you got to hope that Santa hits the chimney right and comes out straight. A lot of times he was getting caught up on the side and things like that. So, when we did get it right, Santa would come flying out and hit the first telecentric lens, something similar to this. That's not it, but basically you hit the first telecentric lens, it'd start rolling, it'd hit the second one, start rolling to the third one, and then the third one would knock into a golf ball, which then would turn the laser on. So for the fourth stage of Rube Goldberg, after the golf ball falls into the little cup on the back of the nutcracker, the weight of that actually closes the jaw of the nutcracker, which activates the button on the laser pointer. We used a 532 nanometer, 50 milliwatt laser, and we put that laser through a focusing lens, and this focusing lens has a 16-inch focal length. So what we did is we put our balloon right at 16 inches, and when the laser gets activated, it goes to the focusing lens and bursts the balloon. The part that was difficult here is the fact that we had to be right at that focal length to get it to burst. Otherwise, it would just put like a tiny little pinprick in it, and it would just leak air. So to get that dramatic effect, we had to set everything up just right to get that explosion of the balloon. And I know it wasn't that easy to see in the video because of that, but you know, that's why we're doing this, so you can see like some of the more intricate parts of this.
Okay, so for stage five of our Rube Goldberg project, this is the part where we had a little bit of difficulty building things, and this is where a lot of the building came into play. So after the balloon explodes in the previous phase four, we actually had the balloon attached to a string through a PVC pipe, which is what it was running from. And on the other end of where the balloons actually exploded, as you can see, we ran through a couple, we have a pulley in the ceiling here. And the pulley is actually holding the string down, which is attached to this PVC pipe here as well. And on the end of this PVC pipe, we actually have a boxing glove for a little holiday spirit in there. Now, it's being holstered down through a PVC leverage right here with a sandbag just on the bottom so it doesn't tip over. And what we actually did was we actually took a picture of Fred and modified it to look like the Grinch. So at the end of this step, when all is said and done, the punching hand will go into the Grinch, which in turn will hit the soccer ball, initiating step 6 of our Rube Goldberg.
Good.
Okay.
So for phase 6 of the Rube Goldberg, once the soccer ball falls off of the ladder, it comes down and hits the basketball, which is resting on these 2x4s, and the basketball will roll down the 2x4s and actually activates all of the lights that you see here. We have a switch that's basically on top of a surge protector that we had, so it was kind of just triggered by the ball rolling over it. And then basically we have fishing line running across the front path of the ball that when it hits it, it actually pulls down on the right side of the structure you see over the basketball right now. And that pull actually flips the golf ball up a little bit and starts it on its path where it rolls all the way across and then falls into the funnel on the train, which at that point activates the train.
So for the final phase of our Rube Goldberg project, after the train is triggered from the golf ball, we actually have it wrap around this elegant catapult that we built here. And at the end of its tracks, we actually have the train stopping itself via a remote control that we have rigged here from a wooden dowel. So the train's actually going to run into the remote control and stop itself from the pressure we have behind the remote here. And we have a candle sitting on top of the train, which is burning the whole way, just taped down to the train so it doesn't wiggle off as it's moving. And as the candle's lit, the string from our catapult here will be pulled back tight enough to the point where when the candle is actually under the string, the candle will just burn right through it, releasing the marshmallows into our hot chocolate.
So happy holidays. That's how we did our Rube Goldberg project. And hopefully we don't see any marshmallows for a really long time. Really? All right, honestly.
That worked horribly.
That was horrible.
Joe! You are honestly an idiot.
Only